Hi there, my name is Jacqueline Snyder, and I am bringing you workshop number two, which is called Establishing Time and Place. This is the second workshop in my series of five workshops on the course Create a Story, Begin with the Bones, which is creating your main character and the time and place that your main character is living in throughout your book. First of all, I'd like to talk about establishing time. Time is the year and the era that your main character is living in or living through. I realize that when you're writing your book, your main character may move through time, may move through different eras and different years, and so it's important to do research and to know accurately what was happening in the places where your character was living throughout the years in your book. This is extremely important because it brings a genuine solidity to your character that will ring true to your readers. If you don't take the time to do the research and to know what the current fashions were, what was politically going on in a certain place, what was socially going on in a certain place, and you make up your own ideas of what you think might have been happening, some of your readers will know that the information that you're creating is inaccurate, and you will lose credibility with your readers. And they may think that you just didn't want to take the time to do the research, and it's never a good thing for your readers to not believe in your own credibility, because you want them to accept your characters and you want your characters to come to life for them. The second part is establishing place. You need to not only know geographically where your main character is living throughout the different stages of your story, but you also need to know the cultural, political, societal happenings that were going on around your character during these times. And some of them are quite local, they're quite related to where they were living and don't span the whole world. And your character can walk from one very different cultural place to another in the same year. What do I mean by that? For instance, right now living in Montreal as, say, a 30-year-old woman would be a very different experience than living in Afghanistan right now as a 30-year-old woman, for example. The culture, the society, the way that women are treated, the education, the health, everything about these societies may be quite different. And so when your character moves through different geographical locations, it can really change their experience, even though they're the same character and they have the same personality inside. So it's important to do this research for you to make your main character richer and more solid, and so that you know them better, but also for your readers, because then when your readers are really getting into your main character, whoever she may be, they will know that it just feels right to them, it rings true, and they might even find out some historical things that they really didn't know related to geographical locations and eras, and you know, giving your readers the knowledge not only of your main character but also of the world that your main character lived in is a real bonus. It's a real plus for the reader because it's an education. When I go back and read Jane Austen's novel, such as Pride and Prejudice, the way that she constructed the sentences, the way that people acted and were expected to act, and the different societies and the social constructions were so different than our own now. And, you know, they went around in carriages, they didn't have cars, everything was just so different that it was fascinating to read about it. And it was probably the time period that she was living through, of course, and so she was very knowledgeable about it, but it rang true. Everything fit together like a puzzle, all the pieces came together. And so if you don't make this effort, all the pieces of your character won't come together for your reader, and therefore the book won't feel as solid to your readers. And you know, you want them to come back for more, you want them to read more of your books after this one, so it's really worthwhile to take the time and effort to create a character that is not only known to you, but is known to them in time and place. So thank you very much, and I'll see you next week for the next in our series. Have a wonderful weekend. Peace and love, everyone.